Hey everybody, it's Alma. Welcome back to Keto Meets Menopause. Hey everybody, it's Alma, day four of the sugar challenge. Guys, getting ready to hit the trail. We got like almost 3 inches of rain last night. Gonna see what it looks like. All right, join me.
Hi, beautiful Brushy Creek Trail. She's glowing this morning. Flash floods last night. Good morning. Hey, sweetie. Oh, there's your face. Good morning, princess.
They are not gonna go anywhere anytime fast. Have to go around there. Little schedule. Good morning, guys. Good morning. Good morning, bye. All right, guys, before we do this little mini haul, check it out. It's 12:57 on Monday, June 4th, which means we are, how many days? 4 days into our lovely little, no artificial sweeteners and no sugar alcohols. Limited to stevia, erythritol, monk fruit, yep, and xylitol for gum. And I have 22,859 steps. Daisy, you want to cook? Everybody, so Daisy and I have a haul for you. All right, so it's a mini haul, mostly protein. I've got my son here from college. Oh my gosh, she is just into everything. I've got my son here from college and he requires lots of protein. His favorite things are bacon and chicken wings. So here's what I got. I got this package of chicken thighs to make some more arroz con pollo. David loved it, so good. And good price, $5.15, 99 cents a pound, guys. This is over at Randall's. Then I found some ground beef because he loves tacos and it's 50% off. So I got this for him. I'll stick it in the freezer. Then check these out, guys, 3 pounds of bacon, 48 ounces, 3 pounds of bacon. Guess how much? Guess, no. Guess again. Nope. Guys, $9.99 a package. $9.99 for this. So I bought it. Guys, make sure that you look and say and make sure there is good fat as well as the meat on it. Look at those cuts. They're all good. Daisy, are those good cuts? Yeah, I thought so. So yeah, look at that. 3 packages of bacon, $30. Stop, Daisy, you silly girl. She's trying to eat the bacon. Packaging. I also got some queso fresco. Sandy, look what I got. I am so used to buying my frying cheese, and I know there's a website that talks about all the different types of cheese that you can use for frying cheese, and I totally forgot that queso fresco is one of them. So we're going to give it a try, see how good it tastes. And then I have some cilantro, got some more Parmesan chips, some Asiago chips. I got some grapes for Matthew. I got some more butter for Matthew to make his eggs. And what did I get? Because he's just a mess in the kitchen. I got this for him, some liquid eggs. It was buy one, get one. And then look at these wings, guys. Check it out. They were 50% off the lowest price. So I got this package of wingettes for $3. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I bought all of them. 6 packages of their wingettes. All of them were 50% off. So I got all of this here. Protein. Hey, Keto Mad. Mike, Marnia. Look, I almost look like I'm doing a Momo. Month of meat only. Check out Mike from Keto Mad, guys. He is doing a month of meat only. Month of meat only. And he's encouraging our friend Deborah to do a week of beef only. I believe she started yesterday. Rotten dog. You do a rotten girl. All right, guys. So we are doing meal prepping. All right. Here's what we have going on for meal prep, guys. It is, what is today? Today is Monday. And we're sitting now at 2 o'clock, about 23,500 steps, and we are meal prepping. So I'm gonna make some fried cheese with the queso fresco. It says it's 10 servings, we'll see, I don't know. So just weigh it out. Keep your barcode for scanning into my Fitness Pal and you're good to go. I have my first package of bacon being cooked. Look at all that bacon drippings. So 3 pieces left on that, and then I'll get started on the second batch. My son said, Mom, make it crispier. He came down and made it some eggs, and he's like, crispier, please. Bacon will go fast because of myself, David, and of course my son, who will eat a zillion pieces a day. And again, making it in my George Foreman grill. You can see it's cooking in there. Yep. Woo, yummy. So we're gonna take this to the stove. Here we go, guys. Yep, I've got about a tablespoon of bacon drippings in there. And then, here we go here. Guess what I'm making, guys? Some more arroz con pollo. David loved it, loved it, loved it. This time I did not use boneless, skinless. Chicken was 99 cents a pound at Randall's this week, so I'm using the skin on, which of course is great for us as far as fat content. So let's see what this happens. Let's see what happens over here, guys. I'm gonna go ahead and put our cheese on there, see if it fries up really well. I put the bacon drippings in there just for flavoring. All right, guys, so here is what the frying cheese looks like. Now, it's gonna release a lot of milky looking product. Let it kind of go through that phase. Keep on checking in on it. Cook at least at a medium heat, and then just keep watching it. And once it gets to this point, you are good to go. And then just let it cook on both sides. Make sure you have plenty of room to flip these. And a really good nonstick pan, all right? You probably don't even need any grease whatsoever, especially if it's like one of these copper skillets. And then just let it go, guys. But it will quickly go from a normal to burn, guys. I added about an eighth of a cup of chicken broth. And there it is, simmering away. Let that cook for about 30 or 45 minutes. Make sure it gets cooked since it has bone in. You need to make sure you cook it a little bit longer than you would if it was skinless boneless. All right? All right, guys, here we are with the arroz con pollo. I've taken the chicken out, placed it in this container, and inside here is the chicken grease as well as a little bit of chicken broth and cumin, garlic, onion, salt and pepper. Yummy. When I was cooking the chicken, I did add some green onions and fresh cilantro. So yeah, we have all of that. We're gonna dump in our cauliflower. Make sure the flavor from all the drippings in the pan get mixed through thoroughly. Ooh. Then set your chicken back on top and let it simmer for about 5 to 10 minutes. You'll know when it's ready. Since we are doing our challenge right now, I'm really trying to be good about doing individual meals so I can really precisely account for my macros. All right, so what I did was for Matthew, so I washed and got all the grapes off the stems. I made some arroz con pollo. David loved this, guys. Delicious, delicious. Cooked bacon for all of us. This is two packages of the 48 ounces. Again, $9.99 this week at Randall's. And cooked some cheese, the queso fresco. Here is my bacon drippings. I actually have a little more here. I'm waiting for it to cool off. And yeah, guys, so that's gonna wrap it up. Let me explain why I did this, guys. Bacon is grab and go all the time, and then the arroz con pollo is good for chicken and rice, is good for if I am tired and I don't feel like cooking, I have something to go to instead of having to cook something that night. So that's why I did that, and throughout the week, you'll just see what I'm gonna do with the rest of the items I purchased, as well as I took some pulled pork out of the freezer that I had cooked, and one of my chicken casseroles I took out. So those are great items for David. And then I will eat probably a little bit differently. All right, guys, have a blessed day. Bye-bye. Thank you so much for allowing me to spend time with you. If you haven't already done so, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and hit that notification button so that you'll know each time I post a new video. All right, guys, have a great day. Bye-bye.
Joyce Wednesday, it's so neato. Now here's my wife to teach us keto. Pork rinds, rah, rah, rah. Carbohydrates, blah, blah, blah.